Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we are going to explain the square wave voltage, explain the charging and the discharging of a capacitor in a series RC circuit fed by a square wave voltage, and explain the effect of the capacitance and the resistance of the circuit on the charging and the discharging processes.
Square wave voltage. Look at the closed series circuit. We have a closed switch, we have a lamp, and a function generator which provides a square wave voltage at a frequency of 250 Hz and at an amplitude of 9 volts. The second figure is the graph that represents UG as a function of time. Now I will turn on the simulation so that you can observe the graph of UG versus time. Observe. Now I will pause the simulation. Okay, pause. Now let's analyze the graph. First remark or first note is that the voltage is periodic, because it repeats itself identically during a constant time interval, which is equal to 4 milliseconds as shown in the figure. Now, this constant time interval is the period of the voltage. The voltage is periodic, so it has a period. Now, the period of the voltage is equal to 1 over the frequency. The frequency of the generator is 250 Hz, so 1 over 250 Hz is 0.004 seconds, which is equal to 4 milliseconds. So this is the period. Now, what happens during each period? Now, in the figure, during the first half period, the voltage is maximum. So it is equal to the amplitude of the function generator, which is equal to 9 volts. In the second half period, as you see, the voltage is zero. This is the square wave voltage.
The figure shows a square wave voltage on the screen of the oscilloscope, so that during the first half of each period, the voltage is equal to a constant value E, and during the second half of each period, the voltage is equal to zero. E is given by this formula. E is equal to SV times Y, where SV is the vertical sensitivity or the amplitude gain of the oscilloscope, and Y is the number of the vertical divisions measured relative to the time axis. The period of the voltage is given by this formula. T is equal to VB times X, where VB is the horizontal sensitivity or the time base of the oscilloscope, and X is the number of the horizontal divisions measured over one cycle.
In this experiment, we want to study the voltage across the capacitor during its charging and discharging in a series RC circuit fed by square wave voltage. So here we have a resistor of resistance 1000 ohm connected in series with a capacitor of capacitance 100 nanofarads. The resistor and the capacitor are connected in series with a function generator. Observe, the function generator is adjusted to provide a square wave voltage. Now we want to display the voltage across the capacitor and the voltage across the function generator on the screen of the oscilloscope. So I will connect channel 1 across the capacitor and channel 2 across the function generator. The metal terminal, the ground terminal of the oscilloscope is electrically common with its metal chassis, so we don't need to connect the ground of channel 2. Observe the curves on the screen of the oscilloscope. The upper one is for the function generator, and the lower one is for the capacitor. During a half period, the voltage provided by the function generator is maximum. During the same time, the voltage across the capacitor increases. This is the charging phase of the capacitor. At the end of the charging phase, the voltage across the capacitor becomes maximum. We say that steady state is attained. During a second half period of the function generator, the voltage becomes zero. This is the discharging phase of the capacitor because the voltage across the capacitor decreases. And when the voltage becomes zero or constant, we say that the steady state is attained.
Focus, please. This is important.
Now, let's generalize what is observed on the previous experiment. In this circuit, we have a capacitor of capacitance C, a resistor of resistance R connected in series across a generator G delivering a square wave voltage. So that during the first half of a period, UG is equal to E, and during the second half of a period, UG is equal to zero. The ground of the oscilloscope is connected to point B. And since the phase of channel 1 is connected to point M, so channel 1 displays the voltage UMB, which is equal to UC. And since the phase of channel 2 is connected to point A, so channel 2 displays the voltage UAB, which is equal to UG. This figure shows UG and UC on the screen of the oscilloscope, while the lower figure is a diagram that shows UC and UG as functions of time during one period T of UG. We observe that during the first half of the period T, or between 0 and T over 2, we have the charging phase of the capacitor. UG is equal to E, and UC starts 0 and increases gradually until it becomes maximum and equal to E at the instance T1. At this instant, we say that the capacitor is totally charged and the steady state is attained. And then the value of UC remains equal to E between T1 and T over 2. The charging phase is divided into two parts. Between 0 and T1, we have the transient phase, and between T1 and T over 2, we have the steady state. Now, during the second half of the period, or between T over 2 and T, we have the discharging phase of the capacitor. We observe that UG is equal to 0, and UC starts maximum, which is equal to E, and decreases gradually until it becomes equal to 0 at the instance T2. At this instant, we say that the capacitor is totally discharged and the steady state is attained. And then the value of UC remains equal to 0 between T2 and T. Also, the discharging phase is divided into two parts. Between T over 2 and T2, we have the transient phase. And between T2 and T, we have the steady state.
Let's study the effect of the resistance of the circuit, the capacitance of the capacitor, on the duration of charging and discharging of the capacitor. Here we have the function generator adjusted to provide a square wave voltage at a frequency of 300 Hz and amplitude of 10 volts. Here we have the resistor of resistance 480 ohms and the capacitor of capacitance 500 nanofarads. Let's move to the graph. The vertical axis represents voltage in volts. The time axis represents time in milliseconds. One division on the time axis represents 1 millisecond, and each division on the time axis is divided into 5 subdivisions. So each subdivision represents 0.2 milliseconds. So here we have 0.2 milliseconds, 0.4 milliseconds, 0.6, 0.8, 1, etc. Let's start the simulation. Observe. Now I will pause the simulation. Okay, the red curve represents the voltage across the function generator versus time, and the blue curve represents the voltage across the capacitor versus time. Now, look at the blue curve. The blue curve reaches its maximum value, which is 10 volts, or the steady state is attained at a time of 1.2 milliseconds. So, with this value of the resistance, 480 ohms, and this value of the capacitance, 500 nanofarads, the voltage across the capacitor
reaches its maximum value at a time of 1.2 milliseconds. What happens if we increase the value of the resistance? For example, I will take the value of the resistance as 600 ohms and I will keep the value of the capacitance of the capacitor as 500 nanofarads. Observe. Okay, I will pause the simulation now. With this value of R, 600 ohms, the steady state is attained at a time of 1.5 milliseconds, which is longer than the previous time, than 1.2 milliseconds. This means that as we increase the resistance of the circuit, the charging process becomes slower because it takes longer time. Now, in this study, I will focus on the charging process, but everything I explained about the charging process is valid for the discharging process. Now, what happens if we increase the value of the capacitance of the capacitor, keeping the value of the resistance as the same original one of 480 ohms? For example, let me take the value of the capacitance as 660 nanofarads. Observe. Okay, I will pause now the simulation. Now, the steady state is attained at a time of, at this time, which is approximately equal to 1.6 milliseconds. So, when we increase the capacitance of the capacitor, the charging and the discharging processes become slower. They take longer time. So, we conclude that as we increase the value of the resistance or and increase the value of the capacitance, the charging and the discharging processes become slower. Now, what happens if we decrease the values of R and C? Let's start with R. Let's take R as 320 ohms and the capacitance is still 500 nanofarad as the original value. Observe. Okay, I will pause the simulation now. It is very clear that the charging and the discharging processes become faster. The steady state with this value of the resistance takes place at a time of 0.8 milliseconds, which is shorter than the original value of 1.2 milliseconds. Now, what happens if I keep the value of the resistance as the same original one, 480 ohms, but I will decrease the capacitance to 330 nanofarads. Observe. Okay, pause. Again, the charging and the discharging processes become faster and the steady state is attained at a time of 0.8 milliseconds. So, as we decrease the value of R or and the value of C, the charging and the discharging processes become faster.
According to the previous simulation, we can conclude that the time to reach the steady state during the charging and the discharging processes depends on the values of C and R, so that when we choose a larger value of R or and C, charging and discharging processes become slower. Then the duration of each process increases. And when we choose a smaller value of R or and C, charging and discharging processes become faster. Then the duration of each process decreases. Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.